to speak for a Black Agenda Report. Black Agenda Report is also part of the Black Is Back Coalition, which was formed back in September of last year. And by November 7th of last year, we were able to put together a march on the White House involving about 250 people. Most of us in the Black Is Back Coalition are confident that the movement does not need some magic wand or killer application, mostly because such things don't exist. What we do need are organizations that are willing to confront power, willing to identify who the enemy is and to call them out, to make sense of emerging realities to as many people as we can reach, and to involve as many people as possible in forceful and sustained opposition to those who do harm to the people. A real movement breeds a culture of resistance, a widely held belief that it is right to resist, that it is virtuous to speak truth to power. That culture of resistance is what made Black America the most reliably progressive anti-war demographic in the United States. It was not that Black people were smarter than anybody else. We were just less confused. We had a better and a clearer idea of who the enemy was. That was yesterday. Today, our job is exponentially more difficult because Black people, who were not too long ago the collective rock of progressivism, are more confused about some things than most everybody else. In the real world, Blacks have been pushed to an even lower level of hell by the Great Recession on top of the previous recession. It has been an unmitigated disaster in which Blacks have fared far worse than every other major group. But the Pew poll shows conclusively that Blacks are the most upbeat about the economy of all groups, and that a large proportion actually believe that they are better off than before the Great Recession. This is madness. And this madness, this great historical anomaly, can all be explained in one word. What's the word?
Obama.
It turns out that Obama is the killer application for the other side. He is their secret weapon. His very presence in the White House is a narcotic, a hallucinogen that causes all of the so-called traditional base of the Democratic Party to lose contact with some degree of reality. But it is most destructive in Black America. It was as this great crisis of the Black American polity was unfolding that the Black Is Back Coalition for Social Justice, Peace, and Reparations came into being. It was clear to the coalition that unless and until Obama's pass is revoked in the Black community, we could not be able to organize effectively. For Black Is Back, breaking the Obama spell is the must-do task for a renewed movement for social justice and for peace. And there is nothing complicated about it. You simply tell the truth. Obama works for Wall Street and the militarists. That is the truth.
Yes.
If we play around with these essential truths, we defeat ourselves. The definition of defeat is a Black America that is asleep. Right now, there is a determined effort to use the Tea Party's white nationalist ravings to mobilize a circling of the Black wagons around Obama. thus diverting attention from the fact that Obama works for Wall Street and the militarists.
Thank you.
Yes. Those same forces will try to morph the NAACP and organized labor's October 2nd march in Washington into a rah-rah rally for Obama and the Democrats. We at the Black Is Back Coalition anticipate that this conference will endorse the October 2 march, and we agree, and we will participate unless that is made impossible. We believe that there are many NAACPs. In fact, NAACP activists have been part of the Black Is Back Coalition from the very beginning. And we believe that we should encourage those chapters and those individuals that are serious about speaking truth to power. And the same thing goes for labor. But when we march, no matter who we march with, we must speak the truth. And yeah. Obama must get no pass, because that is to give a pass to war and to Wall Street. Thank you.
Contemplating following Glenn for that. He's going to give my thoughts.